For spine, I would say it's a dramatic change. People sometimes bear unnecessary pain and drag themselves for this fear, which should be actually shut off. Even if, let's say, sensitive areas of spine where we sometimes have to handle, there is nerve monitoring, which tells you every fiber you touch, is it relevant or not, whether you should dissect it further or you should stop or you should do this and not that. So that thing has transformed everything totally. MRI tells you where you have to go, what is the extent. So spine surgery, that myth actually should be shut off. And we are in that phase of shutting off. We still get people who tell us that, okay, no, this was done and we are fearful of the fact that we might get paralyzed. No. If there is really a risk, scientifically quantifying, a doctor will tell you, we will tell you, yes, there is a risk. We'll tell you the risk in percentage. Even if you talk to people that, okay, my grandfather was operated for spine and he became paralyzed. That's a question. And that's the myth running in the family. And then they just don't want to get operated for a fully treatable condition of a spine. But when you try to convince them, show them that this is there, it is not happening. No, those were the days where people were grappling in the dark because the evolution of science was not that there. If you talk to a person who was operated, let's say 30 years back, he will give you a very bleak opinion about something which is right in those eras. Everything is very scientific, very evolved. The diagnostic tools have evolved, the surgical tools have evolved. The outcomes have been dramatically different. Even in cases where, for example, glioblastoma, or where even the survival after diagnosis was less than a year, surgical methods, the extent of surgery, the results, the additional chemotherapies, the radiation therapies, the various other newer modalities, the quality of life and the quantity of life, they have changed.